contributors.
On Sesame Street, you're going to see a lot about the letters E and M and the number 8. Right, Elmo?
No!
Yes, you will?
No!
What do you mean, Elmo? You are so going to see a lot about the letters E and M and the number 8.
No, 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 no!
Was it something I said? I think Elmo may be angry at me, but I don't know why. All he keeps saying to me is no. Oh, I wonder what I did.
No, 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 no!
Elmo! See what I mean? But I don't remember doing anything to make him mad, but I guess I must have. Oh! Wait a minute. There may be a way to find out if Elmo is mad at me. I'll ask him. Yeah, asking questions is a great way to find things out. Elmo, are you mad at me?
No!
He's not mad at me. See, asking questions is a great way to find out things.
No, 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 no!
But he's still saying no. I wonder why. Oh, no. I wonder if anything's wrong. Oh!
Telly, what's the matter?
Have you seen Elmo?
No, why?
He keeps saying no. That's all he says. No, no, no. I thought he was angry at me, but I asked him, and he says he's not. Oh, I hope he's okay.
Oh, I'm sure he's fine, Tim.
No, 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 no.
Though I see what you mean.
Yeah, this is terrible. Why is he saying no all the time?
Well, now relax, Telly. We'll just go find him and ask him what's going on, okay?
Yeah.
Elmo!
Elmo!
Come on, Telly. Elmo!
One, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Now Billy Bob asked Betty Lou to go out for a ride. Said he'd come on over, wait for him outside. Well, somehow she forgot to ask some more about this ride. Or you can bet that Betty Lou would sure have stayed inside. Oh, you gotta ask some questions. That's how you get to know you'll be riding in a car or on a buffalo. Oh, you gotta ask some questions. Whenever there's a doubt that you're wondering about, ask and find out. Now Jimmy's sister Mary Jo brought home this little gift, and without asking questions, Jim opened it real quick. He ripped up all the wrappings and he looked inside the rim. Then suddenly he got the drift. The gift was not for him. Oh, you gotta ask some questions, or you might get upset that the gift you thought was yours was really for your pet. Oh, you gotta ask some questions. Whenever there's a doubt that you're wondering about, ask and find out. Well, Jerry called Samantha Sue and said, Samantha, hi. Can me and a few friends just kind of drop on by? Samantha, who's a friendly sort, at first was quite content. And then she got to wishing, she asked just how few he meant. Oh, you gotta ask some questions. Ain't hard, ain't no question. If you plan just two friends or plan for 23. Oh, you gotta ask some questions. Whenever there's a doubt that you're wondering about, ask and find out. Whenever there's a doubt that you're wondering about,
has anybody got any questions? In that case, I'll just go on home.
Oh.
Oh, sure is fast. I wonder where he went.
Oh, Savion, have you seen Elmo?
Yeah. Was he acting funny? Was he saying no all the time? Where was he?
No, he was happy, having a good time. We were over at the schoolyard.
In a minute, Elmo.
But Savion said that a minute ago.
Okay. I got an idea.
What?
Hop on and hold on real tight.
Real tight?
Yeah.
Okay. Keep still. Keep still. How's
holding
that?
On?
Yeah.
Good. Because I'm going to give you a piggyback ride and play basketball at the same time.
Oh, get out of here, Savion. You can't do both.
Watch.
Easy, easy.
We had fun.
And he didn't get angry and start saying no?
No. He was happy.
When was this?
This was early this morning. Well, I gotta go teach a tap class. See ya.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Whew. I guess we can stop worrying.
No!
Oh, no. We can't stop worrying. Elmo!
Elmo! Telly!
Oh. Oh! It makes me so mad when I comb my hair and have to pull and pull until my head hurts. I've been angry all day. First, my little brother took the last orange and he didn't share. Then I couldn't find my favorite socks, and I had to wear these dumb old ones that I hate. Then I had to pick up my room, and just when I finally got my toys put away in the shelf, makes me very, very angry. I can't stand this anymore. I hate it. Oh, I'm so mad I could scream. Ooh. What do you want?
Do you want part of my orange?
Well, maybe things aren't that bad, but they aren't so great either.
And now presenting your alphabet favorite, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the sublime Miss M.
There's one letter you can't ignore. It begins mailman, moss, and matador. Magic, mug, and much, much more. And where would we be without them? You got to have M. On a misty meadow on a night in May, what if the M words all went away? No mist, no mister, no moonlit night. Why, even the meadow would fade to sight. And where would we be without them? Oh, you got to have M. At a lovely dinner in a charming spot, what if the M words suddenly were not? No milk, no menu, no fancy meal. And missing his mustache, how bare he'd feel. I mean, don't we need all of them? Oh, you got to have M. Could we take it down now? Now, I'd like to bring out Ms. M. Singers, the M.E.S. Millie, Mona, and at the end, Madeline. You know, people often come up to me and say, oh, Ms. M., Ms. M., there are other letters of the alphabet. What is so special about the letter M? Don't these people see that the letter M has a point right in the middle and two strong lines on the sides? And don't they know this letter makes the most wonderful sound? Mm-hmm. And that's the sound of something. The M words
mouth.
Let's see your tongue. Ooh, look at that. You got a nice tongue there.
Look at my suit.
Oh, I got a tongue too.
Yeah.
Oh, don't touch my tongue.
What?
I say, don't touch my tongue.
Oh.
It tickles when you touch my tongue.
Oh.
My froggy feet.
Oh.
See, those are my froggy feet.
Oh.
You have feet too?
Yeah.
You have an elbow?
Yeah. You got an elbow too?
I got an elbow, sure. Yeah, probably got an
where
elbow.
Is it?
Yeah, it's at the end. It's in between my hand and my shoulder.
Uh-huh.
You know where your shoulder is?
Yeah.
Where? Yeah, up that's here. The shoulder, all right. And let's see. How about where's your tummy?
Yes, it is.
Yep, that's the tummy.
You have tummy?
I got a tummy too. See?
Down there.
Yep. No, oh, no, right about here is my tummy.
Oh.
Oh, don't do that. I'm ticklish. You touch a frog in his tummy, and you tickle him. You want me to tickle you? Tickle.
Elmo!
Wait a minute. Why are you looking for Elmo?
Not that it's any of your business, Fix-It Face, but I just had a great time with him. There I was, on my way to Oski's, minding my own business, and then I saw Elmo coming. I wanted to hide because he's always so happy. Oh, no, not you.
No.
No? No, yourself.
No.
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 No. No. No. No.
Hey, come back here. So I gotta find him. Why are you looking for him?
Because we want to know why he's saying no. And when we find out, maybe he'll stop.
I hope I find him first!
No, 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 no! No!
Elmo!
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 Elmo! Elmo, wait!
And now, my world-famous talking dog will say the word yes.
No.
I said my world-famous talking dog will say the word yes.
No.
Say yes.
N-O. No.
Please say yes.
No.
Just one little yes.
No.
Listen, if you say yes, I'll take you to a movie.
No.
How about a ride in my taxi cab?
No, no, no.
Why won't you say yes? Do you hate me?
Yes!
Yes! Thank you. He said it. I knew he could say it.
It is I, the Count. They call me the Count because I love to count things. I was just playing my beautiful organ. Listen to the lovely notes. Ah, beautiful. But you know what is even nicer than playing the notes? What is even nicer is counting the notes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 beautiful notes. Ha ha! Yes! I play 8 notes, they sound like this. When I play them, I can't miss. First, I play them one by one. Then I sing them just for fun. La 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 la. First I play, then I sing. But counting is my favorite thing. Counting is my favorite thing. Come, let us count the notes together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, what joy! Just can't wait! Everybody, count to 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8. Beautiful notes, ha ha! Oh, boy, do I love counting notes! And you know the wonderful thing about these notes? I can play them and count them another way. I play 8 notes going down. I play 8 notes all over town. First I play them one by one. Then I sing them just for fun. La 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 la. First I play, then I sing. But counting is my favorite thing. Counting is my favorite thing. Now count the notes backwards from 8. Here we go. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Oh, what joy! Just can't wait! Everybody, count to 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8. Beautiful notes, ha-ha! Oh, I love counting those 8 notes. Counting 8 notes is twice as much fun as counting 4 notes. Or 4 times as much fun as counting 2 notes. Or 8 times as much fun as counting 1.
Saying no.
Well, Maria, Elmo's been practicing.
Practicing what?
Well, Kelly, practicing saying no. No. It's very important to know how to say no. Isn't it, Maria?
Well, yeah, sure, but...
Elmo needs to know how to say no when someone wants Elmo to do something Elmo doesn't want to do. Well, Elmo needs to know how to say no. Don't do that. Or no, Elmo doesn't like that. Isn't that right, Maria?
You know, Elmo, you're right. It is important to know how to say no. But you know what? You don't have to practice anymore because you're really good at it.
Oh, thanks, Maria. But that's because Elmo practiced.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Next time you're practicing something, tell us so we won't worry about you, okay?
Okay, Kelly.
Okay.
Well, I guess I can go now.
Okay. Bye, Elmo. Bye, Kelly.
Bye, Maria.
Bye, Maria. Hey. You know something, Elmo?
Huh?
Even though you had me worried,
that was great, the way you practiced no. Well, you're real good at it, you know that?
Oh, thanks, Teddy.
Do you think you could help me practice saying no? I need to know how to.
Oh, sure, Teddy. Just say no.
Okay, here it goes. No.
Not bad, but Teddy needs more practice. Yeah.
No.
Again?
No.
Again?
No.
I think that it is wonderful that I can see a star when it's so very far away. Hello, faraway star.
I think that it is wonderful that I can hear birds sing when outside everything is still. Hello, bird on the wing. Me think that it is wonderful to eat me food all up, especially at supper time, or breakfast time, or lunch time, it not matter. Hello, delicious food.
I think that it is wonderful that I can smell a rose. I'm so glad that my nose knows how. Hello, sweet-smelling rose.
I think that it is wonderful to hug my teddy bear. It doesn't matter where we are. Hello, Teddy, my bear. I think that it is wonderful.
Me think that it is wonderful.
That I can see a
that
star.
I can smell a
that
rose.
I can hear to eat me food.
To
all
hug
up.
My teddy bear.
Yes, it is wonderful.
Me think that it is wonderful.
I think that it
is wonderful. I think that it is wonderful.
When outside everything
it
is
doesn't
there.
Matter where we
especially
are.
At supper time.
Good night, faraway star.
Good night, bird on the wing.
Good night, delicious food.
Good night, sweet-smelling rose.
Good night, Teddy, my bear.
Good night, faraway star.
Good night, bird on the wing.
Good night, delicious food.
Good night, sweet-smelling rose.
Good night, Teddy, my bear.
Good night, faraway star.
Oh, hey, Kelly. Yeah. What are you trying? Are you trying to roller skate? You call that skating? Ah! yeah, you're real good at that. Yeah. Ooh, yeah. Whoa, be careful. Ooh. Oh, be careful. You might fall. Look out, you might fall. Ah. Yeah. We're real good at that. Yeah. What a joke.
La 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 la. Why? Wee! Hi, Kelly. Hi, Frankie.
Hey, Big Bird. Hey, you gotta see Kelly trying to skate. It's really funny.
Hey, Frankie. You shouldn't make fun of Kelly. I mean, she's just learning. It takes time. Yeah, I'll bet Kelly will be a great skater someday.
Yeah, right. Forget about it. Not as good as you or me, I bet.
Hey, you never know. I mean, there was a time when I wasn't a good skater at all.
Really?
That's right. Everyone in my family could roller skate. Everyone in my family but me. I can tell you it doesn't feel great when everyone else can roller skate. Everyone in my family but me. Dad said it doesn't matter, just keep trying hard. Mom picked me up when I fell down in our backyard. and even my sister helped me, though I wasn't sure she would. So I kept trying, and then one day I could. And then everyone in my family could roller skate. Everyone in my family and me. So today when I see a kid having trouble the way I did, I try to help, I don't make fun, 'cause I'm thinking back to when everyone in my family could roller skate but me. So, what do you think, Frankie?
Gee, Big Bird, well, I think maybe you and me could help Kelly with her skating.
Yeah. Hey, Kelly, how'd you like a few lessons?
Yeah, come on over, Kelly.
Here we go. Lesson number one.
Through some of these old pictures of me in my youth. For instance, here's a shot of me when I started off as a frog's egg. And then the egg hatched and I became a tadpole, sometimes known as a polywog, which grew little legs. Then eventually the tail fell off and yes, I became a frog and went into show business. Yes, as I look at these pictures, sometimes it makes me sad. But I'd rather not just talk about it. I'd like to sing about it. Play that piano, Sam. Once I was an egg in a pond so wet. But that was long ago, and I wasn't born yet. Then from that groovy egg, a polywog came out. And yes, that was me, just a wiggling about. Just a wiggling about. Oh, the life I led in that wild and crazy bog. I was just a carefree, playful polywog. Swimming without stop, living for today, wiggling through my youth in a polywog kind of way. But to every polywog, there comes without fail that crazy day when they lose their tail. So long, wiggly tail, goodbye, polywog. I started growing legs and became a frog. Yes, I became a frog. Now the time had come to leave the old pond, that waterlogged cradle of which I was fond. Kick my brand new legs, get to the top. Get out of my water and take my first hop. Well, life just goes on. I've hopped a lot since then. I've kicked up my heels again and again. But as far as I may hop, there always are days when I miss that old pond and my polywog ways. Thank you, thank you, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. Sorry, I kind of got carried away there.
No, no, no!
Yeah, that's great, Telly. Let me try that. No!
Wow. Maybe Chicago doesn't need to practice.
Elmo, huh? I'd like to try.
No! Whoa! Larry's good at saying no, too.
No!
production of the Children's Television Workshop. No!